My name is Stith Wiggs. I'm a research technician for Darren Mueller. I operate a lot of his field program, planting, combining, and working in the field. We're in Kanawha, Iowa right now, and behind me is about a 1 acre field of sunflowers. We plant 1 acre of sunflowers, 1 acre of corn, and 1 acre of soybeans in a 3-year rotation. And what we do is take the sunflowers and we inoculate them to try to get them sick with white mold. They're really susceptible to white mold, and they build up that inoculum in the soil and presence. So then this sunflower field, we just inoculated it for white mold. We'll let these plants grow another month or so. Hopefully they get disease. Then we'll mow them and incorporate them into the soil to spread out all of the diseased plant tissue. Next year, we'll plant soybeans into this area, and then hopefully that increases the soybeans' chance to get white mold, and then we can run trials, whether that's seed treatments, commercial testing, fungicides, cultural practices, varieties, and see how they perform against white mold. So sunflowers are really susceptible to white mold. So almost every single sunflower out here, we stabbed the back of it with a wooden stake that had been dipped in white mold infested potato dextrose broth. So that's just white mold that we blended up and then stab it, create an entry wound, and then that'll infect the head and get the plant sick. So that's why we plant sunflowers. It's a very good host for white mold. There was some stabbing through the cups. Styrofoam cups, we might have to use plastic next year because people are sticking their stake right all the way through. So I talked a lot about white mold and sunflowers being a really susceptible host. So this is an infection of white mold on a sunflower that was from last year's inoculum. So this is not even affected this year. This is from last year. So you can see where it's brown instead of green. It's much softer here. And then if I turn it around, you can see a lot of the white mycelial growth and then some of the black where it's already destroyed that part of the sunflower head. So we're hoping that those wounds that we put on the back of the plant will grow into this